Hi out there, everybody. This is Mr. Kowalski coming back to you again with another recorded fourth grade music lesson for you. And today we're going to be taking a look at a new song. All right, today we're going to be taking a look at a song today about a guy who gets into a fight. Well, it's not a guy who gets into a fight like with another guy or another lady or something like that. This is about a guy who gets into a fight with an entire city. Right, we're going to go ahead and find out about this guy who gets in this fight with an entire city full of people. So let's go ahead and find out what this is going to be all about today. Ready? It says here, it says, the guy's name was Joshua. Okay, and it says the title of the song is Joshua Fit the Battle of Jericho. Now, Jericho is the city, right? Joshua is the guy. And when it says fit right here, fit is like another way of saying fought. Okay, so it's like a slang way of saying fought. Like, he meant fought when they wrote the title of this song. So this is called Joshua Fit the Battle of Jericho. So we're going to get a chance to sit back and listen to this song about this guy who gets in this fight and this battle with this city called Jericho. Some of you might recognize it when you hear this song. We'll see what it sounds like. It goes like this. Ready? I'll put the words up for us while we're listening. And here it comes.
Joshua Fit the Battle of Jericho.
First one.
You may talk about your king of Gideon. You may talk about your man of Saul. He's not like good old Joshua at the battle of Jericho.
Then we go back.
Joshua did the battle of Jericho. Jericho, Jericho. Joshua did the battle of Jericho. And the walls came tumbling down. To the walls of Jericho. He was with a spear in hand.
To red.
Just with the battle of Jericho, Jericho, Jericho. Just with the battle of Jericho, and the walls came tumbling down.
And here's the end.
And the walls came tumbling down. And the walls came tumbling down. And the walls came tumbling down. And the walls came tumbling down.
Whoo! Fast and exciting. What a great song out there. Yeah, this song was called Joshua Fit the Battle of Jericho, like we said, or Joshua Fought the Battle of Jericho in there. And our job today is to be able to sing these red words here and then be able to sing the red words that come in the end too as well. So now, in these red words, I don't want you to get confused. This is nothing to do about a guy fighting against Cherry Coke. Okay, usually after we get to listen to the song, somebody says, Mr. Kowalski, why are they talking about Cherry Coke? Right? Joshua Fit the Battle of Cherry Coke. Cherry Coke. Cherry Coke. All right, sounds like Cherry Coke. It's not Cherry Coke. Right? It's right here in front of us. It's actually Jericho is the name. And like I said, Jericho is the name of the city that Joshua ended up fighting against. And we'll talk about that story here in a little bit too. But first, our job is to be able to sing these red words all the way through. But remember, we're not singing about Cherry Coke. We're singing about Jericho. So I'm going to go ahead and grab the handy dandy step bells. Got a lot of up and down the steps that happen in this song right here, too. So we're going to go ahead and start with the easy part, the part that always ends these red words here, where it goes like this. Right up the steps and back down, and it goes like this. And the walls came tumbling down. Just like that. Ready? Nice and easy, right? Up the steps, and then right back down like this. And the walls came tumbling down. Did you see that? Watch again. And the walls came tumbling down. See what happens? The words say the walls came tumbling down, and look what happens on the bells. And the walls came tumbling down. Which way did we go on the bells? Right, we went down the steps on the bells. And I think that's sort of a cool thing. That's a cool thing in music that sometimes we call it word painting. You don't have to remember that. But word painting means when the notes in the music do what the words say. Like the words say, the walls came tumbling down, and the notes go down the steps. So that's kind of like I said, that's that word painting that we talked about. So one more time, and the walls came tumbling down goes like this. It's going to walk up first and then walk right back down. I'm going to sing it. You sing it when I get done. Ready? And the walls came tumbling down. Your turn. Yeah, now don't give me some little halfway. Now don't give me one of those, right? Give me those good, strong singing voices and say, and the walls came tumbling down. Ready, go. There we go. Now, we're going to do that a lot in the song, right? We're going to do that word painting part down those steps a lot in the song, in all those red parts when they come back. Now, if we go back to the beginning of the song, we have a lot of those Jericho, Jericho, not Cherry Coke. All right. Jericho, Jericho parts. It's going to go like this. Ready? Goes, Joshua fit the battle of Jericho, Jericho, Jericho. So kind of walks right up the steps. Ready? Walks up there to Jericho like this. Joshua fit the battle of Jericho, Jericho, Jericho. So let's try that together. Let's try that first line. Joshua fit the battle. It's bouncy and it's fast. Listen to it again. Joshua fit the battle of Jericho, Jericho, Jericho. Let's try that together. Ready? Bouncy. Here we go. Joshua fit the battle of Jericho, Jericho, Jericho. There it was, yeah. Now we do the same thing again up the steps. Joshua fit the battle of Jericho, and the walls came tumbling down. And we know that part comes next, right? So let's do the second line. Joshua fit the battle of Jericho, and the walls came tumbling down. Let's finish that. Ready? Joshua fit the battle. One, two, ready, go. Joshua fit the battle of Jericho, and the walls came tumbling down. Awesome. This is an easy one. Now let's try the whole red part all the way through. Ready, Joshua fit the battle. One and a two. Ready, everybody go. Joshua fit the battle of Jericho. Keep going. Jericho, Jericho. Do it again. Joshua fit the battle of Jericho. When the walls came tumbling down. Yeah, there it was. Awesome. So now your job is to sing those red words every single time they come up. First couple times through, I'm going to help you out on the bells, but I might fade away from those bells and see if you really got it by the time we get to the end. All right, ready? It's fast, it's bouncy, it's exciting. Give me lots of energy in this one. Ready? Here it comes. Run. Two, three, four, one, and two, and ready? Here we go.
Joshua hit the battle of Jericho, Jericho, Jericho. Joshua hit the battle of Jericho, Jericho, Jericho. And the walls came tumbling down.
Ready?
Come and talk about your king of Midian. You may talk about your man of God.
First verse.
There's none like good old Joshua.
Ready? Back to the red words.
Joshua fit the battle of Jericho.
Keep going.
Jericho, Jericho. Joshua fit the battle of Jericho. And the walls came tumbling down.
Number two.
Up to the walls of Jericho. He marched with a spear in hand. Go blow those ramparts, Joshua cried. Cause the battle is in my hand.
Back to red.
Joshua fit the battle of Jericho. Jericho, Jericho. Joshua hit the battle of Jericho when the walls came tumbling down.
Number three.
And the ramparts they began to blow and the trumpets began to sound.
Then Joshua commanded the children to shout
and the walls came tumbling down.
Ready, back to red.
Joshua hit the battle of Jericho, Jericho, Jericho. Joshua hit the battle of Jericho. And the walls came tumbling down.
Here's the end.
And the walls came tumbling down. And the walls came tumbling down. And the walls came tumbling down. And the walls came tumbling down.
Nice! Good job on those red words. Now, next thing we're going to do is jump into these red words right here at the end. Super easy, but they can be a whole lot of fun. Ready? It starts out really whispery, really, really quiet. Ready? It starts out right here and it goes, right? It just stays on this bottom step for most of this whole ending part. Ready? It goes like this.
And the walls came tumbling down. And the walls came tumbling down.
Right? Just stays on that same step the whole time. And like I said, real whispery, kind of hushed and mysterious sounded. So let's try that all together. And the walls came a tumbling. Ready? The first two lines. One and two. Ready? Here we go.
And the walls came a tumbling, tumbling down. And the walls came a tumbling down.
Easy peasy. Yeah, almost like I said, almost like it's a secret, like it's a real quiet thing. So try it again. Ready? The first two lines. One and a two. Really bouncy and quiet.
And the walls came a tumbling, tumbling down. And the walls came a tumbling down.
Good job. Now the third line, we do it again.
And the walls came tumbling, tumbling down.
Now this is where it gets really big surprise. Ready? The very last line is not going to go down the steps like we did before. It's actually going to climb up the steps, opposite of word painting. It's going to climb all the way up to the top step and then do a sliding board all the way down to the bottom like this. It's going to be big. It's going to be loud. It's going to be like a big surprise. The last one is a big, loud surprise. It feels like this. And the walls came and tumbled in. And on down. It goes all the way to that bottom step like that. Ready? So big, loud surprise for that last line like this. Listen to it again. And the walls came and tumbled in. Really big and exciting. Now, the thing that makes it a real big surprise exciting, though, is doing the first three lines really quiet. So I got you it like this. And quiet. That's how it gets loud there at the very end. Awesome. So let's try that whole ending part all together. Ready? And the walls came a tumbling. Ready? One, a two. Start quiet, ready? And it's not until the last line where it gets really big. Ready? One, and two, ready, here we go. And the walls came tumbling down. And the walls came tumbling down. Do it again. And the walls came tumbling down. Now. And the walls came tumbling down. Got it? All right. Now comes the real test then. Now we're going to go back to the beginning, and we're going to try the whole thing. Ready? Now, I'm going to leave those bells over there. I'm not going to use those bells, right? So you take care of all those red parts, right? That refrain, those red parts that come up. I'll take care of those green, black, gray parts there in the middle. I'll go ahead and sing those because we're going to push the magic button on the iPod. And when we push that magic button, it's going to take away their voices. These kids aren't going to sing it anymore. This lady's not going to sing it anymore. It's up to you and me. So you're on those red parts. That's you. Sorry. You're going to have to put up with me singing these parts here. Sorry, you got to listen to me do it. You can join in if you think you know it. But if not, just sit back and let me take care of these parts. And then you guys do the red part. I'll do this part. You guys do that red part again. I'll do this part. You guys do that red part again. And then we'll all do this part here at the end. Okay, this is the really fun part. I don't want to miss it. Ready? So let's go ahead back to the very beginning and let's try it. Ready, set, here comes. Now remember, they're not singing. So it's up to you guys. Ready, go. Joshua. My part. You may talk about your king of Gideon, you may talk about your man of Saul, there's none like a good old Joshua at the Battle of Jericho. Your part, go. Joshua at the Battle of Jericho. Don't you quit on me. Joshua at the Battle of Jericho. Yeah, number two, ready? Up to the walls of Jericho, he marched with spear in his hand. Go blow those ram horns, Joshua cried, because the battle is in my hand. Go, Joshua. Come on. Number three, here I go, ready? Then the ram horns, they began to blow, and the trumpets began to sound. Then Joshua commanded the children to shout, and the walls came a-tumbling down. Your part, Joshua. There's the end, go. Go! And the walls came tumbling down! Yeah! Nice job, folks. Give yourselves a hand. Very, very nicely done. All right, you sound really good. Now, what I want to get a chance to do next is sit back and let you guys listen to a different performer sing this song. Okay, you heard me sing it. I'm going to say, it wasn't great. It's all right. You're allowed to say it. But there's somebody who sings this song much, much better than I did. And her name was Mahalia Jackson. Let's take a look. Ready? Here it comes. Oh, there she is. Ready? Here are some photos of Mahalia Jackson. Now, Mahalia Jackson was an American gospel singer who made this song, Joshua Fought the Battle of Jericho, and many other ones like it, really, really popular in this gospel style of music. You can see there's a close-up picture of her face. Mahalia Jackson right there. And this is a picture of her singing for a big audience full of people, right? She was born in 1927, died in 1971. And check it out. Look at this. Ready? Her singing here at this big audience full of people, that was a really, really big, huge deal, right? Because in the time when Mahalia Jackson was really, really getting to be a popular gospel singer, it was very uncommon for African-American performers of color, like Mahalia Jackson, to be allowed to even perform for audiences of mostly white people, right? So for her to be performing and have an audience full, jam-packed, full house of people, that was a big deal. She was that talented of a performer to get a chance to go in and be a person of color, to be an African-American performer and have a packed house of white audience members getting a chance to listen to her perform. Right. Now, I'm not sure which song it is she's singing in this photo right here. I don't know if it's the same one that we get a chance to listen to her singing. But we're going to listen to Mahalia Jackson perform this same song for us, Joshua Fit the Battle of Jericho. Now, when she sings it, she might sing it a little bit differently than we did. She's definitely going to sing it a little differently than I did. Some of the words might sound a little different. She might even change some words around. But we'll get a chance to hear Mahalia Jackson sing this song, Joshua Fit the Battle of Jericho. So I'm going to go ahead and leave these pictures, and I'm going to scoot back to the beginning of the words so we can follow the words as she sings them and see if she changes any of them around. Ready? So we'll go all the way back up here. I'll tell you right now, she's not going to do the special ending the same way we did. They're going to do it a little differently. So let's see what it sounds like when Mahalia Jackson sings this song for us, Joshua Fit the Battle of Jericho. Let's see if you can find anything different about it. Ready? Here it comes. Right away, it sounds different. It's just a piano.
Joshua fit the battle of Jericho, Jericho, Jericho. Joshua fit the battle of Jericho. Walls came tumbling down, hallelujah.
Just, yeah.
Joshua fit the battle of Jericho, Jericho, Jericho. Joshua fit the battle
she still
of
tumbles
Jericho,
down.
And walls came tumbling down. You may talk about the men of Gideon. You may talk about the men of Saul. But they're not like the good old Joshua. The battle of
Joshua.
Jericho. Hallelujah. Joshua, the battle of Jericho.
Joshua.
Jericho. Jericho. Joshua, the battle of Jericho. And the walls came tumbling down. Hallelujah. Joshua, the battle of Jericho. 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 Joshua, the battle of Jericho. And the walls came tumbling down.
Yeah. The piano solo.
Up to the walls of Jericho with sword drawn in his hand.
Sword drawn.
Go blow them hearts like Joshua. The battle is in my hand. Joshua, the battle of Jericho, Jericho, Jericho. Joshua, the battle of Jericho, and the walls came tumbling down that morning. Joshua, the battle of Jericho, Jericho, Jericho. Joshua, the battle of Jericho, and the walls came tumbling down. Hallelujah. Joshua, the battle of Jericho, Jericho, Jericho. Joshua, the battle of Jericho, and the walls
Yeah. What a cool performance, huh? That's Mahalia Jackson singing that one. Changes things up a little bit, right? She never got to the third verse that we did. And that's all right. But she still was telling the story as it goes all the way through. Changed around some of those words too. Joshua, she said, instead of Joshua, right? And changed around some of those other words and other things too. Well, in the last minute before it's time for us to go, you might have figured this out already based on the sound of the song and the way it sounds. But this is another example of an African-American or a spiritual, right? African-American spiritual. Those slave songs we've been talking about. This train is bound for glory. Now let me fly, right? So now we know that African-American spirituals like this, these slave songs, these spirituals that they sang all those long times ago, often were used as secret code songs about the slaves and sharing secret code messages. So we're going to go back through these words here a little bit, and we're going to take a peek and see if we can find any words that are code words. Ready? Like in the red words. Let's see. Can anybody out there want to take a guess? Now remember, Joshua was a person's name. Jericho is the name of a city. But can you find any words in here that you think were secret code words? Take a guess. What do you think? Battle? Battle? Yeah, excellent guess. But no, not a code word. Not code words. Walls came tumbling down. So we said walls came tumbling down. Fantastic. Awesome guess. But no, not code words. Nope. In this verse, Gideon, Saul. I mean, those are people's names again. Nothing in there. Let's see. Jericho, there's that city's name again. Oh, spear. Like they're going to fight with a spear. marched? Code word? No, not a code word. Then again, there's the battle. Battle's in my hand, and ram horns, those are like old trumpets. No code words. No, not where I did those. There's the trumpets. Began. Joshua commanded to shout, and well, walls came tumbling down again, but we already said no to those. Code words that mean like running away or freedom or heaven. Did you find any? No, we didn't. We didn't find any, and here's why. There aren't any. Yeah! Right? There are no code words in this song. This song doesn't have code words because it's actually a different type of spiritual. There were two types of spirituals that slaves would sing. The first one were those code songs, like This Train and Now Let Me Fly, where they would hide these secret code words in the songs to get a chance to talk about plans for escape or getting away or how frustrated and upset they were with their bosses, and they could hide that language in there. This song is different. This is a second kind of spiritual. This spiritual is a song that helps the slaves to remember old Bible stories. Now remember, the slaves were religious. They believed in the Bible. They believed in the stories that came from the Bible. They believed in heaven and going to heaven and all the good things that were going to come with it. That's what the slaves believed in. But a second type of spirituals that the slaves would sing were songs that helped them remember old Bible stories. Because the slaves weren't allowed to go to school like you and I, right? And most slaves never learned how to read. Most slaves never learned how to write. So if somebody told them a story about Joshua that came out of the Bible, they couldn't just say, oh, wow, I remember that story about Joshua. Let me go home and get my Bible and read it. Because most slaves couldn't read. And if somebody told them what happened in the story in the Bible about Joshua, they couldn't just go home and write down the story so they'd remember it. They didn't know how to write. And they couldn't write the story to remember it. So when people told them a story that they really liked and they made a connection with and they wanted to remember, the slaves would often sing about it. They would sing the story of the Bible story, they said, in the form of a song. And that way, every time they sang the song, it helped them remember the story and helped them remember the connections that they wanted to make to that story. Joshua Fit the Battle of Jericho is one of those kinds of songs. And we're going to find out about the story and why it was such a big connection to the slaves the next time that I see you for music. Oh, I know. Big cliffhanger. Right. So, but we're out of time for today. So the next time that I come back and see you, we'll come back and do a little bit more work with this song, taking a look at some of those other words, and we'll talk about the story that came out of the Bible that the slaves wanted to remember so badly and why this story in particular was so important to those slaves. Got it? So keep this part stuck in your brain. And the walls came tumbling down. Right. Keep these red words in your brain. Don't let them fall out. And we'll get a chance to talk about these again in our next music lesson. Until then, I hope you guys keep working hard. I hope you have a great day. I hope you're staying safe and healthy. And I'll see you again the next time as we find out about this story. I'll see you guys later. Bye.